Almost 50 years after the last mission to the moon, there are still questions the expeditions didn't answer. Now though, thanks to some archival sleuthing, one of those mysteries has been solved, and it turns out the answer is kind of dumb. It all started when the Apollo 15 mission in 1971 and the Apollo 17 mission in 1972 buried some platinum thermometers in the lunar surface. They were planted at different depths from 1 meter to 2.5 meters down, and the goal was to see how heat flowed from the interior of the moon to the surface, which would help scientists learn more about the moon's interior, like if it had a hot core like the Earth, and the rate of internal geologic activity. But they found something they didn't expect. When astronauts visited the moon, they may have altered its temperature just by being there. Although they didn't figure that out until recently. The thermometers reported a gradual uptick in temperature by 1.5 to 3.5 degrees Celsius, and nobody could pin down exactly why. A few things could be eliminated right away, like the sun. Even though temperatures on the moon swing wildly over a lunar day, the probes were deep enough in the lunar soil to avoid the sun's effect. It also couldn't be the probes' power source, as the thermoelectric generators were far enough away from the thermometers to rule them out. But there were still other possibilities, like fluctuations in the moon's orbit, radiation from Earth, or maybe some lasting effect from the astronauts. We didn't know because of a bureaucratic whoopsie. The thing is, each of these probes beamed back temperature data for years. The data were recorded on 7-track magnetic tapes, which were then analyzed and archived. But when the experiment ended in 1977, only tapes up to 1974 had been analyzed and stored away. The rest, from 1975 to 1977, were lost. And it wasn't until 2010 that NASA started searching for old mission data from Apollo and other programs, and lordy were their tapes. Researchers discovered 440 of them had somehow wound up at the Washington National Records Center, presumably right next to where they keep the Ark of the Covenant. 440 tapes sounds like a lot, but it's less than 10% of the missing data, and what was found was badly degraded. In another stroke of luck, they found weekly logs of the probe's temperatures during the missing years at the Lunar and Planetary Institute in Houston. So, after 8 years of searching and analyzing, they finally had all the pieces of the puzzle. The new data showed that the probes kept warming up all the way until their demise in 1977, and the ones closer to the surface warmed first, meaning the heat was coming from above and slowly penetrating downward. That made one scenario the most likely fit. Humans did it. A quick peek at pictures of the landing sites taken by a probe currently orbiting the moon revealed how. Turns out setting up those experiments on the moon involved a lot of shuffling about, and that kicked up the bright, shiny dust on the moon's surface, exposing darker soil beneath. That darker soil absorbed more sunlight, causing the thermometers to record higher temperatures. So after all this time, it was just us. As soon as we set foot on the moon, we were warming it up, which is so typical human. This also means the act of installing the instruments muddled the results of the heat flow experiment. But knowing where we went wrong will help us design future experiments. Maybe we'll keep this in mind when we're kicking up Martian dust one day in the far future. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe. If you could move to the moon, would you? You'd probably have to live in a cave. Lunar real estate agent Trace explains the crazy plan here. One last thing, we could take pictures of the astronauts' tracks today because there's no wind or water on the moon to erode them. Okay, I'm out, but I'll see you next time on Seeker.